Hello, how are you guys doing tonight? Today, whatever. I'm doing good. We decided to waiting on playing Shadow of the Colossus until the weekend, just so that way most of my subs could make it by. Don't know who is here, who's ready to stream, but you know what? I am, so I'm gonna. How's that sound? It's Saturday. You know? Y'all have time to watch me play games badly. This is one of my favorite games of all time. It was one of the incentives for getting up to 75 subs, and I believe we're at 91 now. Or is it sub? God damn it. 91 out of 100. I don't know what to make 100. I kind of put all my good ideas towards the charity event that is happening. Is it next weekend? Let me double check. Yeah, next weekend. 1 week from today is the Vinesauce charity event. I spent probably about an hour or so today making sure I got the graphic for the incentive thing done and setting up what's worth what amount. We're hoping to raise a little bit more than last year so we can make the total amount that we've earned through our charity events around 150,000, which is going to be good. Hopefully this will be out before then, but that will be Saturday the 23rd. So if you are 23rd and 24th, so if you are here and you're watching on After Hours and I'm saying this and it's like the 23rd or something, fucking come to stream vinesauce.com. Watch us play games live. Everyone who is streaming that day is an amazing streamer. You know, there's a reason that, you know, I've been with these guys for like 6 years. Hootie was pointing out last night, I have known these guys longer than most people know people from their high school, which is crazy. Anyway, let's start this game. If you haven't seen this game before, fucking go get this game. I've heard the PS3 port is really good. Am I going to do a 24-hour thing? No. Oh, speaking of dongles, do I have a... Hold on. I gotta do a thing. Where's... Okay, hold on. I'm just gonna add a camera here real quick. Because I need to show you something, DJ. Because you need to know. So the other day, I went to this little small shop. Dongle. I didn't comb my hair this morning. And I didn't shave. I look fucking shit. That's okay. No one fucking cares. Including myself, obviously. Alright, so let's go ahead and get started on this. This game is amazing. It's one of the few games that went for a realistic art style that actually still holds up today. There's not really another game like it. Tonally, I would say it's kind of similar to something like Dark Souls or whatever, in a way. It's a little bit cheerier. Not much. Let me know if the audio levels are fucked or whatever. Yeah, you saw this game in Kmart for $3? Dude, it's worth more than that. It's worth it. Thank you, DonDoran85, for resubscribing for 1 year of subscription. Thank you. I've put the little blur effect that we had on the Star Fox thing on again. Well, thank you, Fluttershy, man. I kind of feel like letting this intro play. It's been about at least a year since the last time. No, more than that. One of the first videos on my channel was this game. Charity incentive dongle album. I'd have to get good enough to play music. I'm gonna shut up and let you look at these beautiful but somewhat grainy PS2 graphics on my really shitty capture card. It's better than not doing the incentive, I suppose. I'll look up when I put out that video. I have an update. I haven't backed up my phone in 53 weeks. Probably bad. So that doesn't tell you a whole lot, but it just kind of gets you set up for what you're about to experience. I doubled the audio on the game, so hopefully it's better now. Let's see. I put out the... It's got to be like a few years ago. Like, no one watches it anymore. I can't tell on the mobile app, but anyway. Oh, did I just load the game? I didn't really mean to load. Serene yet melancholy. That's, yeah. I think I accidentally, loaded an old save. This game is so beautiful despite the just limitations of this game. The Last Guardian is coming out. I have a very, very low expectation on it, just because every time I have a high expectation on a game, it ends up being shit. But, my phone is just blowing up. Hey, Alexia. Again. There's a reason this game is in my top 10 games of all time. I would say it's in my top 5, maybe even top 3. This game is just fucking amazing. The graphics are a bit dated, but they did the best they could. Otherwise, gameplay-wise, it's great. It's a little bit Zelda-ish, I guess. It's compared to Zelda a lot, because there's not a lot of adventure puzzle games that exist. Adventure puzzle is my best way of describing this. In the same way that, like, Undertale could be called a JRPG. It's... I mean, technically it has those elements. This game looked pretty beautiful in 2005. Top off my coffee while it's doing this intro cutscene. Out of This World is a fair cinematic platformer comparison. I think I haven't played the PS3 one, but the PS3 one I've heard runs a little bit better, so you might want to get it instead. But I have the PS2 original, so I bought it on sale for $20. I still think that was an amazing purchase. I suppose so. They are memories replaced by ins and knots etched into stone. This is a fake language, by the way, that they wrote just for this game, because it's beautiful. Blood, young sprouts, sky, and the ones with the ability to control beings created from light.
In that world, it is said that if one should wish it, one can bring back the souls of the dead. But trespassing upon that land is strictly forbidden. I never did play Ico, I suppose I should. Played a bit of it, wasn't impressed. Try and pick up when the cutscene ends. Thou possesses the ancient sword? So thou art mortal. Are you Dorman? You Dorman? I was told in this place at the ends of the world. There existed a being that can control the souls of the dead. Thou art correct. We are the one known as Dorman. She was sacrificed, for she had a cursed fate. Please, I need you to bring her soul back. Bring back her soul, whatever dyslexia. Dyslexia is what I was gonna say. Fuck. That maiden's soul? Souls that are once lost cannot be reclaimed. Is that not the law of mortals? It's left intentionally vague for the first little bit, DJ. With that sword, however, it may not be impossible. Really? That is, of course, if thou manages to accomplish what we askest. Askest? What do I have to do? Behold the idols that stand along the wall. Thou art to destroy all of them. But these idols cannot be destroyed by the mere hands of a mortal. Then what am I to do? In this land, there exist colossi that are the incarnations of those idols. If thou defeat those colossi, the idols shall fall.
I understand.
But heed this, the price you pay may be very heavy indeed. I added a very in there for no reason, sorry about that.
It doesn't matter.
Very well. Very good. I do have every plan on beating this on stream. It's not gonna be today. But raise thy sword by the light. And head to the place where the sword's light gathers. There thou shalt find the colossi thou art to defeat. Go fuck some shit up. I mean, this is pretty much the only story you get. There's a couple other times where it has a little bit of a story exposition, but it pretty much does the rest of it by just... Now be on thy way. It pretty much does the rest of the exposition just by you interacting with the world, which is wonderful. So here's your horse, aggro. X is climb, right? Or is it something weird? Nope. Oops, sorry. Triangle. There we go. Okay, so first thing to note about this game is the UI. This is the most you'll ever fucking see of it. Now I kind of remember where he is, so I don't really have to use this, but in order to give you like a compass, like you have a map when you press start, but it's pretty vague and useless. But if you press O, it'll just point you to where you need to go. There's very little UI. Down in the bottom right, you have the three things. You have which weapon you have out. Let me bring it up again. The pink thing is your grip meter, which is important. And then the red bar is your health. There are only two weapons in the game. There is no switching them out or like upgrading them anyway. You can switch between a bow and a sword, and that's it. That's all the UI you need, and it allows you to have these... It allows the game to be beautiful. It allows it to do its own thing. So again, sorry about the kind of crappy capture card. The AverMedia card just isn't working. So, to make up for that, I'm just gonna use my crappy old Dazzle, but you know what? It works. I wish there was a remake. There is one. It's for the PS3, though, so that doesn't do you too much good. But, and I've heard it's good. I haven't played it, which is... I don't really need to adjust. There are stat upgrades. I'm not gonna, really worry about them. They're kind of hidden. And in fact, the first time I beat this game, I didn't even know it was a thing. But if you eat fruits or lizards, you can slightly increase your bars. But that's about it. This is just a little tutorial thing. This is not an emulation. This is the actual PS2. Some games don't emulate well, and I didn't want the game to look like shit because of it, so I figured I'd rather... there's one in every save shrine. Yeah. I'm not going to spend too much time worried about it. Alright. Yeah, it's not a blind run. I've played this game before. It's one of my favorite games of all time. Because it's fucking amazing. You know, this seems like a bad idea, but fuck it. No. Alright, let's just go for it. Kind of forgot how to beat this first guy, so we're just gonna try some shit. Thank you. It's okay, I got this, dude. You can calm down. There we go. Oh, I've grabbed him by the taint. Oh, what am I grabbing onto? Oh no, that's his knee. Oh. Is the frame rate originally like this? This is the PS2 version, yes. There may be some frame rate issues just because of the capture card, but it's pretty much like this, yeah. It's one of the drawbacks of the game, honestly. No, fucking shit. Here's where I show my inexperience. Might want to drop off and, No, losing grip. Oh, fuck. Does someone want to pull out a list of, like, the top 10 games of 2005? So that way, we can, kind of compare what else was on the market. He's made out of like stone and fur. No, come on, get up. There you go, dude. Okay, now we can take a little bit of a pit stop. Oh god. Might have to take another pit stop. There are only certain locations where you can stab in and actually do any damage. And those are lit up by little runes. Actually, when you're using your sword light thing, that's actually pointing you to these runes. Not just generally towards them. There's one. I think it was last year at AGDQ or SGDQ, forget which, they did a speedrun of this game, and that was some pretty amazing shit. Oh, hi there. Oh, no. Oh, shit. Okay. Let's take a quick cheeky stab at him. Kind of rest up for a second. I know how to do this, dude. Calm down. I got it. Oh, no. Oh, God. Please stop. Please stop. Fuck. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. Calm down. One more. One more. There we go. You can actually still see me moving about. All right, run away, run away, run away, run away, run away. Oh. Fuck. Is that tentacle porn? That is the joke that everyone makes about this game. And that was the first boss. That was very much a tutorial boss. Just to kind of get you into the mind frame of how this game do. You can save there. Was that 7 hours that I took to beat this game? So it's probably about, what is that? 8 divided by 2 is 4. 4 streams worth? Okay. What I love about this game is it completely doesn't tell you what the situation with the girl is. She's just a girl that you're trying to save. So it could be completely platonic, or it could be, you know, your girlfriend or whatever. Thy next foe is... In the seaside cave, it moves slowly. Raise thy courage to defeat it. Could be his sister. Yeah, that's true. This is streamed from a PS2, yes. I'm using a capture card. A really shitty capture card, but a capture card all the same. One thing I don't like about this game is getting on the horse sometimes is about as fun as, I don't know, shoving ants down your pants. Throwing a brick up your dick. If thou shalt findest an altar similar to that one, offer a prayer before it, and thy wounds shall be healed. I really don't want to do that right now, though, so we're not. If I was planning on quitting, I would do that, but alright, it's on the other side of the base. I kind of forget. There's a couple that I don't really like or care for. I actually think the screen region could be fixed up a bit. Let me do that real quick. Oh, hi there. Getting to see behind the scenes. It's good. Actually, let's unpause. Actually see where the screen is. It's right there. Okay. So he doesn't miss anything, it's just it wasn't in full screen. Or as full of a screen as it could be. Does this game have widescreen support? You know, that's a good point. It actually might. Oh, it does. For some reason. That kind of looks like ass. What's wrong with this? Why do I not like this? Am I just skinnier? I don't feel like that did anything. Does anyone else feel that way? Progressive scan. What does that mean? If your television does not support progressive scan, your screen will go dark. Wait a few seconds and the menu will return. Do you wish to play in... Okay. Okay. Well, looks like my Dazzle does not... Okay, so it didn't like it. I like that it does give you... I mean, this is way more options than any fucking game. Adjust the output to... What do you mean? Like, in Dazzle itself? Can I do that? Hold on. Let's get this right, because if we can make this game look beautiful, then let's do it. Full screen? No. Output. I don't know what the fuck any of this means. What is this? In OBS? No, I've got to have a way of actually watching it myself, because I don't have a capture for it. There's a thing that pops up on the side that allows me to actually change things, I believe. Shadow of Dazzle. If anyone knows what I need to be doing in order to make this look right or do this right, this is a Media Player Classic. I should probably have said that. This is the Media Player Classic stuff. So this is the best one I could find that tearing test, display stats, output range. Oh, I don't know what this means. Okay, well then, this may just have to be a little bit weird, because as far as I understand, the Dazzle doesn't have anything beyond like 480p, which is like great streaming quality. Streaming at 720p, but we're upscaling 480p to 720p, which means that it looks like dicks, but presentation maybe? Okay. Presentation. Presets. Where did you see presentation? Presentation. What? I try and read all the comments in chat, but obviously there are times below output or something. Output range, presentation. Look for aspect ratio. Stretch to window? Is that right? What did I just do? Later, DJ. View video frame override. Okay, view... Oops. Video frame... Override. Override aspect ratio 16:9. I mean, it's still by 4:3, right? You guys are getting a little bit of it chopped off on the sides now. Is this supposed to be 16:9? Currently, the size is like, well, whatever this number is. Can I actually stretch that to... No, actually, that's... So it's less than 16 by... If you have the correct component cables have to have your capture device... I've just got the red, yellow, and white. Go to the PS2 system settings, change the video output. Alright, well, I guess let's go save real quick. I said I wasn't gonna go save right now, but... Wait, where the fuck are we? Okay, there's the temple, right? Just leave it at 4:3? Okay. 4:3, the way our dads played.
Shadow of the broadcaster. Do you guys have the screen region okay now? Did I not fuck anything? 4x3 is best for composite. Okay. Okay. Well, this is, I think, maybe as good as we can do with the Dazzle. And with the settings that we've got. Let's figure out where we're going. I need to go down there. Which I love the way that this game is set up. Let me get back to talking about the game. So I love the way that this game is set up, because you can go to all the areas where all the other guys are. They just won't be there yet. But you can kind of, like, it does feel like there's something to explore here. So it looks like he's just down there, which I, yeah. This game just makes me feel happy and other things. I think it's this way, right? It's a little bit like Zelda in a lot of ways, but instead of having, like, dungeons and items you need, your items are always the same. You can get an upgrade in, like, New Game Plus, but we're not doing New Game Plus. And instead of dungeons, it's just a large boss. It's pretty much just the colossi, birds, and lizards as things that you can actually, like, hurt. I mean, fruit. This, yeah, I think that's why I kind of compare this game to Dark Souls, because it's just sort of like, it doesn't tell you much. It's just like, hey, you're here. You're trying to get this girl back to living. And go. Here, right? Yeah, should be right here. Just wasn't quite close enough. I find it easier to sometimes turn if I use the circle button to turn. I forget how you get started on this guy. I have a feeling that a lot of them you have to, like, get their knee to do something so that way you can bring them down to the point where you can actually. Alright. If you say he's easier to fight on foot, then I think I'll take your advice. Generally speaking, that's, the case. I don't remember how to get him down. Can you actually kill a colossi by shooting a million arrows? Oh, there it is. Alright, we're just gonna aim for this foot, even though the other one will go up. Maybe I should pay attention to the fact that he's turning. Yeah, let's deal with that. You have to do the last hit with the sword. There we go. See, if you're good at this game, you don't fuck up the jump or the shot every fucking 5 seconds. Am I going up here? Where the fuck am I going? I don't think this is the right leg to shoot. Is he turning around, like, directly on top of me? Other side of the foot. Aggro, you might want to move. This is not a great place for you right now. This works. Aggro, not now. Not a good idea. Oh shit. Oh fuck. Oh. Don't do this to me, man. Oh, fuck. God damn it! Shit! Ah! Shit! Aggro, time to move. Nope, time to move. Get the fuck out of here, you dumb horse. Let's go! Come on. Aggro, not now. Journey was nice. Journey was a good game. It's probably in my top 20. I only played it once, and it was at, like, this girl I was dating's house. It was kind of awkward, because she was just like, yeah, play this game, and then she just sort of hung out and didn't talk to me for, like, the entire duration of the game. Didn't I stream Journey? No, someone else did. Okay. Come on, get up. So I can hit any of the legs, it looks like. Aggro, I don't know what part of not now this is a bad place for you, you don't understand, but you do you, man. I don't think she knew who I was until after we got done dating. I remember her coming by when I was playing Nightfire and being like, why didn't you show up for our date, and getting really pissy with me, and it's like, look, we didn't have a fucking date. Memories. Memories, memories. Oh. The less time you can be using your grip thing, the better, because
You're gonna use up a lot of it when he starts doing this bullshit. Nope, I fucked up that swing. So, the longer you spend, winding up your attack, the more damage you do. But obviously, there are downsides to that, like he might start just thrashing around randomly. So. Yeah, we're on number two. Also, later in the game, it switches up the spots, so you can't just stab the same spot repetitively. Which I believe is what just happened here. We need to switch spots. I hopefully can hold on long enough to survive his thrashings. Okay. Run for a bit. Cool down. I think there's one on his ass, isn't there? I vaguely recall that being... Oh. There is. Good. There we go. And someone asks, is there any point to running? No, they will always catch you. Even the speedrunners pointed that out. I mean, not that they ran, because there's like a sweet spot, obviously, that you want to stand so that way you can hit by them faster. Last Guardian is made by the same people who made Ico and Shadow of the Colossus. I believe so. I don't know about that. I believe that's the thing. I don't know if they gutted the team and they're under the same name still or not, but I believe it's the same company anyway. Oh, cool. It just keeps me here. Good. I guess I should get around to playing Ico at some point. When I played Ico for the first time, I was just not in the mood for it, and I don't know. It wasn't really what I was feeling at the time. I was really against the idea of, what is it called? Escort quests. And so, yeah. I'll turn up the music up a bit. Oop. A giant canopy soars in the heavens. The anger of the sleeping giant shatters the earth. Turn it up just a bit. Hopefully those sound levels are better. Ico is just such a slow game. I don't know. If it's made by this team, I feel like I should give it some respect. Maybe, you know? But I just wasn't in the mood the time I played it and rented it from Blockbuster. This is when they had the, you can rent any number of games a month, but, for free, but you just pay X amount a month. So I'd run through games fairly quickly, and if it didn't catch my eye immediately. And that's kind of what I had. It has a very similar aesthetic. Profile 720p, fuck. I was so happy to upgrade this to 720p that I kind of got, yeah. Okay. Let me go up to the little shrine thingamajiggy. Is there a lizard here? Can we play with our lizard some? Am I at full health or? Yeah, I am. Okay, so there's no real point.
There's a way you can grab Aiko while falling, I believe. No worries, Schrodinger's dog. Oh, I just got your name. I'm dumb. I guess this game really succeeds on the atmosphere front. Hijack a bird. Don't see any, but I will if I see one. Because that's just... A lot of this stuff like that is just like... It's unnecessary polish. There's a bird. I think the map for this game is actually fairly small, but it feels massive. Just because of the way they laid it out. Oh, I missed the bird. I'm sorry. I'll do it next time. There's only certain lizards that actually benefit you, and I forget what the lizards do and what the fruit do. But, you can play the entire game without getting them. I believe that's what speedrunners do. I didn't know about it until I streamed it, and then it was like, people were telling me, and it was like, okay. I'm guessing that was somewhere around 3 to 2 years ago. I don't remember which one this is. Lizard tails give you stamina. Oh. No, there's a lizard.
Hi.
I'll be right back. Tilda just got home, so I'm gonna take a quick break if that's alright. 2 minutes? Give me a sec. Be right back. Alright, I'm back. I don't know if you guys are yet, but I am. I do not have a PS3. I should. But they're a little bit more affordable now. I don't know if you can do backwards compatibility with PS3 games with the PS4. I might get a PS4 eventually if that's the case, but not right now. I think they're going to be upgrading to PS5 or whatever soon. So the HD collection of this is good. Useful tip: holding X gets you to and keeps you at the full speed of the horse. Flicking the left analog stick towards you, pressing X at the same time while standing still, gets you up to full speed immediately. Doing that while at a full stop full speed stops you immediately. Doing that twice
at full speed, you 180 and continue at full speed. That's a lot of information that I didn't actually process. Okay. There we go. Now, you gotta shoot them twice, because they do pretend like they're dead. Now, is this one of the special ones, or... There we go. No, it wasn't one of the special ones. Alright. Alrighty. So we were going this way. I like the way that his legs do bend with the, Okay, there's something about, like, forward and then X gives you full speed. Toward me and then X. Which one is this? Oh, this is one of my favorites. The special ones have glowing white tails. Might do this one and then, maybe call it? I don't know. I love the scenery in this. This game is so good at giving you the atmosphere of a culture that does not exist at all. You know? I mean, like, just... Look at this. And nothing is, like, really well put together. The map does feel like there was something here once and then now it's dead. This is, yeah, definitely one of the more memorable ones. I ought to do an arcade with this game, honestly. I know it's a little bit grainy, but, you know, we could clean it up. It'd be a little bit challenging, but I don't know.
Thank you, sweetheart.
I know, but I kind of want to see you. Like you. Oh, this is another thing I like. If you go full tilt at a angle that you're not supposed to go on, he trips. But then he'll pick himself back up and keep going at that full speed. It's absolutely hilarious. And just unnecessary quality. Oh, God. Wasn't sure about that one. I do need to get back into painting before I do any more arcades. I also need to get a, stand rather than renting one from school. It's just easier and would make it so that way it happens more often. This is the knight, and it's why he's cool. His face is kind of dorky, but I still think he's cool. He's one of the ones that really do give you that you're fighting something much bigger than yourself, and you're doing something really, really fucking stupid. But what else is there to do?
The camera actually does act fairly well. It has some times that it acts a little bit funky, but most of the time it does a pretty good job of it. Trying to get back down around to this. Climb the tip? Nah, see, that's scrub strategy. People don't know, but there's a secret to this guy. I just gotta find this again. And stand right here. Is this a real PS2? Indeed it is. I guess we're going up then. Please stop noticing that I'm on your sword. Wander, come on. There you go. There you go. This isn't one of the ones where you gotta go to the belly, right? Oh, shit. Oh, there we go. I think he has a back one as well as a head one. Yep, there's the head one. I think a lot of people didn't understand Agro's controls. Why does he naturally avoid trees? Yeah, I mean... There we go. Oh god. Go. Oh fuck. Reading the unused content, I feel like, gives you a good idea of what this game is set out to be and what it is, you know? There was meant to be a couple more bosses, and I think they figured out they were too samey or something. Yeah, there were supposed to be 24 colossi, is that right? That sounds right. I thought it was like 2 or 3 more than the original 17 or 15 or whatever it is. I mean, courses are kind of dumb, so that aggro controls like a dumbass is totally normal. I want another game that allows me to have this control scheme, you know? Okay. We're out of this stage of the boss fight. Though that said, like, the bull and the lizard in the arena, those are, like, too small. Like, they are not colossi. They are fairly large SUV-style things. There are supposed to be 24, there are 16, which means there are 8 unplanned, 8 that were planned but not used. And that just kept cutting. Okay, I don't want him to hit the plate, actually.
Okay, good. Whoa. The lion one? That's what I mean. There's the lizard one, and then there's the bull or lion or whatever it is. Alright, I believe his last spot is on his back, if I remember correctly. Oh, missed. It's on his belly. It's not a tramp stamp. His name is Wander, yes. Like, Wander Over Yonder, which is actually something I just realized is a thing. Ah! Come on. Come on, game. Give me this. Where the fuck am I? Game, please. Okay. I don't know how I got here, but... Leap of faith time. Yep. No, oh. No, the shimmies are real. Stop it. Stop it. I think the bird one might be my favorite, honestly, because it... I don't know. Feels good. There we go. One more. He is not happy about this, but it's okay. We're good. We're good. Go straight through his belly button. And there we go. The bird is next, really? I'm dead. I honestly don't know, Dave. I haven't played this game in a couple years, so... It's okay, dude. The horse is next? Why doesn't the Colossus just grab the little shit? I don't know if he had proper hands. I mean, one of his hands was just a sword. I think that's part of it, is that they just don't have fine motor control. Like, most of their attacks are just them wiggling or stomping on you or slapping whatever appendages they've got at you. Oh, the snake bird, the desert snake bird. That one's really cool. Some of them have proper hands. I'm using the NTSC version, yes.
Thy next foe is, in the land of the vast green fields, rows of guiding graves. It is giant indeed, but fearful it is not. I'm not sure why it being giant would make it scared of things. That seems kind of backwards, actually. Actually, being giant does kind of prevent you from being killed by most things. Anyway, go kill that shit.
Oh, instead of doing the dumb, like, Ocarina thing, like in Ocarina of Time or whatever, you just call his name, and if he's far away, you start yelling.
Well, I mean, let's figure how long it takes for me to kill one of these guys, and then how quickly can you kill a fly? And if the fly was actively trying to kill you and, stabbing your arteries and stuff, like, yeah, I can see how it could be a thing. Like, it's moving around too fast, but flies also fly. That is something key to their design element, if you will. I kind of want to go back to the original, because I believe that if you go back, like, you can see the ruins of him. I just want to do this once, because I don't think I ever have. So he's over here, right? It's not going to point me in the direction of where the old ones are, because there's no point in going back to them aside from just, like, wanting to. So, horse flies. What is Roach from? I don't recognize the name. I think I like aggro the best. What about a jumping spider? There's fruit there? Did I miss the fruit? Oh. There is not a location. Yeah, that's a good point. There is a tree right there. I'll get it on my way back. When you get there, press circle next to it while your weapon's unequipped. I don't think this game actually goes up to 60 FPS, no. Oh, Witcher. I didn't ever play The Witcher. I've heard good things about The Witcher. So, tailless whip scorpions? Are those the flying scorpions? A tailless scorpion just sounds like a spider. Or maybe a crab. It's more of a crab, isn't it? The PS3 version, it does go up to 60? Wow. See, that's innovation as far as video games go. Aren't scorpions arachnids? I don't know. Honestly, I don't want to know much about insects and bugs and arachnids and creepy crawlies. I'm gonna call them creepy crawlies because then it doesn't sound like I don't know what I'm talking about. It just sounds like I'm an asshole. Actually, no, it actually does sound like I don't know what I'm talking about more than I'm an asshole. But whatever, you know what I mean. Anyway, those things. The tree's all fucked up? Were they like this? No, that's just roots. Okay. Putting my weapon away, as per suggestion. I know there's like a speedrun mode that you can do, where you just replay the bosses. But here's where he was. Seems a little bit like desecrating him if I climb on him, but you know. Going into remembrance mode. Sure. Does this just mean that I fight him again? Because I don't really want to do that necessarily. I'll try it. Why not? Fuck it. I've never done this, so I don't know what it is, but it's probably the you get to replay it. It's a time trial style fight. And the film grain effect to make it look old. It's cute. It would be sort of like, A very aggressive spider, I guess. Let's not Google Botfly. Let's not do that. I don't hate myself enough to... Don't look at botflies unless you're ready for a really bad time. It's one of those things that gets added to the... Vine Sauce tag on Tumblr, along with, like... You'll never believe what we extracted from his zit. And it's like, great. I'm glad that's part of... what they do. Alright. Well, do I get anything for doing this? Other than satisfaction? That was pretty fast in comparison to the first time I did it. So how long did that take? Like, under a minute? If something was doing enough damage to just, like, kill you in under a minute, and it was the size of, like, a gnat? Definitely more than a minute, but I don't know. If you're watching on After Hours, go back and time that little section. You're at about a minute and 20 in, so you can go and check. Double check how long that took, and then see whether or not that's like... If you could kill something that was trying to kill you in that amount of time. If it was smaller than your fingernail. You get explosive arrows and a parachute, and a mask, I believe. Maybe go to the well in the temple, or look at the statue in the temple? Maybe. What do I think of wasps or pissed off hornets? I mean, I'm not a fan of really either. Because, like, bees, I get bees. Bees are cool because they do good stuff. But wasps are just kind of assholes, you know? Like, you don't do enough for the world to be this much of a dick. I'm sorry, wasp. And if there are any people who love wasps here... Listen, I'm not a wasp apologist. Like, I'm not down with wasps. And, I'm just gonna jump off the side here. Here we go. Go. So you said back and then... Okay, so that's stop. And then back and then... Oh, that is a full tilt. Cool. Cool, that's actually really helpful. So if I'm just riding somewhere, I can just use that. Alrighty. Now there's gotta be a fruit around here somewhere, right? Some people are flipping their shit about a fruit. I don't see it. But let me get back to the situation with the bees and the wasps, because I don't want to leave that on the cliffhanger, as I often do. Bees? They're cool. They make honey, they pollinate flowers. If bees die, we die, you know? Wasps, like, we can survive without wasps, I'm fairly certain. Although someone inevitably will... correct me and be like, well, if we didn't have wasps, we'd have an overpopulation of I don't know, something awful. It's really hard to think of anything worse than a wasp. I think next year we ought to do a charity where we help wasps or bees. Fuck wasps. What the fuck? Did I just climb? I didn't even know you could do that. I just climbed a tree. Well then. Where does this get me? Anywhere? Oh, and bees die when they sting you. Like, wasps, they can keep being an asshole for the rest of their lives. Alrighty then. I did find the fruit, but I just happened to totally fuck it up, so it's directly above me, actually, so I need to back up a bit. If wasps die, then sharks will stop fearing the land and kill us all. Oh, I see. Aggro? Kind of fucking up my aim here. Alright, there we go. Alright, where did that go? Now then. So, my health meter just got a little bit better. Also, wasps help majorly with pollination. Really? Really? God damn it. Get out of here, you wasp apologist. PS2 sound, for reals. Alright. So where's the one that we're actually going for, rather than just fucking around killing ones we've already killed? It's kind of an asshole move to kill the guy, then kill his ghost. Like, kill his memory. Like, realistically. So he should be going at full tilt now, so there's no real reason to go again. I'm pretty sure wasps don't pollinate flowers. I think you're actually a wasp apologist, and I'm gonna say no. Sharks are chill. Sharks get a bad rap, you know? Same with wolves. You know, a lot of people want to kill wolves. They're like, wolves are dangerous, but in reality, I think there's like less than one human death per year due to wolves. Like, you just, wolves, especially in America, are ultra, ultra scared of humans and will just leave you alone. Apparently the European ones are a little bit more aggressive, but sharks are chill. They don't care. Like, they understand what divers are now after a few generations of understanding divers, and now they don't attack them. They're curious. They're huge. They're scary. I mean, that's a thing, but don't sharks kill less people than falling vending machines? Yeah, that sounds right. So. Wolf puppies are cute. What is it? The, believe it's the North American Indian dog? Hold on. This is important. I'm gonna stop stream for half a second to show you guys this shit. Because you guys need to know about this dog. North American Indian dog? Something like that. It's not an official breed of dog, and it's adorable. If you like wolves, these exist. Here, hold on. Can you see that? Yes, you can. Okay, cool. Look at this dog. They're huge. But look at these puppies. I'm pretty sure this is just a straight up wolf, but I mean, like, look at this. Look at that. It's fucking cute as hell. And this one. They're cute. Anyway. This game. Indeed, it is a pupper. So, now you know about North American Indian dogs. They're apparently huge. So, you know, take that into consideration. They probably act like huskies, where they need to be run. Like, they need to run and walk all the time. They can't just, you know, not be active dogs. Which is why I'll never have a husky. Because I won't be able to take care of a husky, right? Mac with a Vengeance. That is such a good name. Where is this asshole? I mean, again, this is another occasion of me calling something else an asshole when it's really me being an asshole, but yeah. Come on, aggro. I don't mind spiders in my house. I like them there. Nerdcube is chill. You can allow him to post a link. This one I like. Aggro, you might want to move. There's a large horse coming towards you. Large skeleton horse, just saying. The Northern Inuit dog. Let me see this. That's pretty cute. Kind of looks like a wolf as well. Yeah, I like more chill kind of dogs. Dogs that don't like going on walks, you know? That kind of thing. Because that's basically my lifestyle. I'm very sedentary. You know, I'm basically fucked up mind, body, and spirit, but whatever. That's who I am as a person. I accept myself. And, corgis are apparently kind of assholes. Related note, you might want to move, Aggro. Hi there. Not the most graceful move for our hero, but... Oh, sorry. Shit. Oh, shit. My boyfriend thinks lobsters are cute. I mean, not really? But I like the cuddliness of like a you know, furry animal like a dog or a cat. I'm not a huge fan of, I forgot how you start with this guy. I think it is something like this. Like, shoot him in the butt. Oh, no, there it is. Good thing his butt is made out of stone, or else he might have... Oh. Oof. Armadillos are dumb. Armadillos are really dumb. I don't think you guys understand this. I've talked about this before. Armadillos, they might look cool, but they are the dumbest fucking creatures on Earth. Because they have two defense mechanisms, and both of them do not work with cars. One is to stand still. Actually, they have three mechanisms. One is to stand still and be hissing and try and run away. That doesn't work, because cars move faster than they do. If that doesn't work, they try and jump at them. They try and jump at things that are attacking them. True fact, armadillos can jump like 3 feet straight up in the air, right? Now, that's problematic when you jump directly into the front of a car. And then lastly, their last defense mechanism, which does not work with cars because they're already dead, which is probably the smartest of the options. This animal is dumb because the pseudo-predator that was created less than 50 years ago kills them. I mean... Hello? Please? Please let me on? Nah, I can't. Alright, well, I'm just doing this way then. I don't think this is the right way. I think I've made a mistake. Hi there. Please stop. Please don't jiggle around too much. It'll just make it difficult for me. No. Oh, I said don't. I said don't do that. Don't do this thing you're doing. Horse, please. Horse, please. No, please. Oh, okay, okay. Okay, just kind of hold still. I don't think he can get me here. Oh, no, shit! Okay, he needs to chill the fuck out a bit before we can continue on with this. Horse, stop doing what you're doing. Oh, okay. I think he has one on his back, too. Oh, God. Oh, shit. Okay, does he have one on his butt? Kind of recall that there being one on his butt. Is that true, or am I just making shit up? I think I'm making shit up. Oh. That butt wiggled up. Yeah, I couldn't get the controls to cooperate with me. So, we ended up not doing the back way. We need an angry rev remote. That it took people this long to realize that we need one might be an indication that I'm not a terribly angry person. Aw, that booty. Ow. I think it's pretty much confirmed that there won't be a Shadow of the Colossus 2. I don't know. We'll see. We'll figure out what we're getting as far as emotes once we get to 100 subs. For now, if you're thinking about subbing, consider saving that money for the charity marathon because it is like... Oh, I need to unsheathe my sword in order to see spots. Right, okay. Whoop. Okay, we're just gonna roll down, I guess. Someone is banging on the wall. Apparently angry that I'm playing a video game. Either that or they're just hammering a nail or something. Okay, so we're doing this the dumb way because this is not working. Also, I think your grip depletes faster if you're holding a sword. Oh, there we go. There's a spot. Almost missed this one. There we go. Are you gonna... Maybe bend your neck down a bit? Thank you. Alright, there we go. Oh, shit. I think it's just the one on this guy, isn't it? We're pretty safe here, I think. I think you can do it in like three or four stabs if you're good. I'm not, so it's gonna be more than that, but... Alright, girl, you might want to move. Big ass horse here. Their HDR implementation is apparently a huge hack job. Honestly, I don't mind it when games use, like, weird trickery methods to make the game look good when it shouldn't. Because that's what you should do? As a developer? Like, you trick the hardware into doing something cool. Like, or trick the player into thinking it looks cool. Like how in, Dark Souls, you can see other sections of the world by looking around, but it's still a map painting, you know, backdrop. It's not an actual, like, you don't actually see that far. But the illusion is good enough, and it's connected together well enough that it convinces you. I think this is one of the saddest ones, because he does seem just like a gentle giant. Can't catch me?
Yep.
Okay. The Colossus hair is just an alpha mask. That's fine. Whatever works, man. Okay, the best one's up next. Okay, this is the bird one, then we'll do the bird one, and then we'll stop. Yeah. What sucks is that you are the bad guy in this. And I like that. Like, it's not as simple as you are good guy, you are bad guy. Not really. I say that you're the bad guy. But, like, you're a guy who is misguided and is trying to do... He's trying to get his loved one back by any means necessary, including and not limited to a lot of bullshit. And they give you all of that, you know, stuff. It's that whole what would you do for love thing. Yeah. Well, there are 16 colossi, so where are we?
Thy next foe is... It casts a colossal shadow across a misty lake. As it soars through the sky, to reach is no easy task.
So someone in chat just explained what an alpha mask is, so I'm gonna go ahead and quote them, but basically I've always understood it as basically being like a PNG, like a semi-transparent, image. Like, most of it you can see, but then there's a bit of it that's transparent. I don't know why they're banging on the wall like I'm doing something. Apartment living, everyone. I think it's reasonable to assume that I can stream in the middle of the day on a Saturday. So, yeah, it's just sort of a little trick. So all the hair in this game is apparently done with that. I remember, I think it was Halo 2 is the first game that I noticed that had bitmapping. And I was blown away by that. And nope, missed. You know what? I should probably have my horse because it's kind of a walk. I was just going to go on foot, but...
Dongle hair.
Fourth of the way through. Rev, my man. Apartment living is a joke. We share the... Well, I mean, I don't know if that's why he's banging on the wall. He could be nailing something to the wall or moving something. What is he playing on? Like, PS2? I think he's just moving something. Sounds like they're moving a dresser or something. Or maybe they're just having rough sex. It's hard to tell. I can stream on a PS2 with a capture card, although this capture card's not very good. There's a few that you can get. Dazzle is one of the cheapest ones you can get if you're interested. And then you can also get AverMedia, but the reason we're using my not-as-good Dazzle is because... The AverMedia, which is supposed to be better, is not working right now. And I don't know if that's just a common problem with it. I know, Yul has the same card I do, and is having a lot of problems. Yeah. You want to see a boss fight? This game is only boss fights. Oh, hold on. Excluding a little bit of time that you spend outside, I believe. Huh? Fuck. Hold on. Let me get a little closer. I'm just looking at the black pixels on the screen and trying to hit something. Yeah, it's one of the ones with a shiny tail. Oh. Okay. Let's go. Okay. We're gonna have to get a little bit closer. How do I do that? I should just pronounce it Joel, even though that's not right. But yeah, he has the same problem with his AverMedia capture card, and he has some... I believe the way he put it was, Oh, I got it. So that makes my stamina a little bit better. Wait, is there another one? Thought I saw another one. Did I see another one when I was... Joel. Joel seems so weird, and I've been pronouncing his name Yol for 6 years now. Oh, that's another one. That is another one. I did not imagine that. Though it doesn't appear to have a tail, so... I think I just killed the lizard that I got the tail from. And that achieved nothing. Okay, well... Aggro, get your ass over here. Let's go. I got the tail already. So it's not like I'm missing it. Alright, I need to get down there. I'm thinking that there might be a little bit of a divot in... okay, let's slow down a bit, Aggro. Sorry. I asked Yol how to pronounce his name, and that he says that I'm pronouncing it right, but he doesn't mind Americans pronouncing it wrong, which is why he goes by Joel. Alright, so there's a little walkway there. The unfortunate part about this is it tells you directly which way you need to face in order to go directly to him. That is not the best way of getting there. I imagine if I jump off, I die, so I can't just do that. No. Okay. Okay. Words are hard. I need to stop restructuring sentences halfway through a sentence as well. I do that a lot. You know, I'll be typing something out, and then I'll go back, and I'll... realize that I want to fix, like, you know, maybe a couple words of the sentence, and then all of a sudden I've changed the sentence's meaning entirely. And it gets really confusing, and it sounds like I'm an idiot. Which is true, but that's not particularly why I'm an idiot in that moment. Okay, how do I get down? People are screaming at home, I'm sure. I think there's a way to get down. Alright, let's slow it down a bit. TV Trope says it's pronounced with a J. Well, people have wrong opinions, too. And who knows who wrote the Vine Sauce TV Tropes page. Which is crazy to think that we have one. Go past that bridge. Let's just keep going a bit. Maybe if I just follow this cliffside around, we'll find it. Alright, you have a good time then. Let's just keep going around and see if we can find any little curves in the earth or something that we can, take down. Maybe it's this bridge here. I appear to be going entirely the wrong direction. So maybe it's across the bridge? Go back. You gotta be a little bit more specific than go back. I believe this just takes us to the giraffe, doesn't it? I always have a hard time finding this one. I remember this now. There are a couple that I have a hard time with. So. Yeah, if I go across the bridge, the one I came across. Yeah, that Vokeru, I remember him doing that. Can I catch these guys? No, I think they're just sprites. I don't think they're... Yeah, I need to go to the other bridge. There we go. Alright. There we go. I like that that is a thing. I never really understood how to control aggro. But the little suggestions that were given do help. Okay. Once he's at full tilt, pressing back, though, does slow him down. So go. Cool. Because I don't like kicking him repetitively. It just makes me feel like a horrible human being, honestly. But, you know, there I am doing it. If he starts to slow down, we'll kick him more, but... You can kill the doves? Why would I do that? Okay, so it's around past here. Maybe it's along that cliffside. That seems familiar. Come on. Just go a little bit faster. I'm gonna stop killing the innocent every... That is entirely what this game is killing innocent things. You know? Do the ends justify the means? My mom used to play Ocarina of Time. Not actually just to play Ocarina of Time. Like, she never actually beat a dungeon or really did anything in it aside from if we got Epona going, she'd want to play and just ride the horse for a bit. Made her happy, so we let her. I believe this is one of the trees that has fruit, isn't it? Really not interested in stopping, because you have enough health in the beginning. It's really the lizards that I care about, because the extra stamina does have a noticeable difference on your ability to play the game. After you've collected enough, anyway. Oh, sorry, sorry! Okay, we can stop going at full tilt, probably, because I can't control it well enough. Alright. Or you could always ask Yule how to pronounce his name. Be like, Rev was pronouncing it wrong. You can run over lizards, by the way. There's probably a lizard in that, that thing, but we're not gonna stop for it. Alright, later, Freelance. This is one of the best ones, though. I think this is probably my favorite. Alright. Oh. That was not the correct way of getting in this one. Hold on. I get this one and the fish one confused a lot on how you get in them, so I'm hoping I'm going to the right one. Let's maybe look around and see if we can see him. I think he's up there. Might just be a tree, though. It's hard to tell. This is good. Good backflip. Meant to do that. Land headfirst into a shallow lake. Very graceful. It's okay, Agro. You can stay here. Don't worry. I gotcha. You're at the right place? Okay. Alright, well, let's just swan dive in then. This is the PS2 version. Go forward in the water. Okay. Is it under here? Forget how you go underwater. Is it X? I mean, this seems to be working, so I guess I didn't really have to swim underwater too much. I like that there's a little bit of a puzzle to get some of these guys. I mean, he's doing this with his hands wet from swimming in water like half a second ago. That's pretty impressive when you think about it. This is definitely one of my favorites. How do I get in contact with Vinny / how did I become part of the Vine Sauce crew? Back when Vine Sauce was much, much, much smaller, Vinny was streaming to less than 50 people. And I was like, hey, I've got an idea for a stream. And he's like, fuck it, I'm going offline right now anyway, so cool. And, because back in the days of live stream, there was actually a hard cap to 50 viewers at a time. And you could change it. But you had to get verified, and a lot of people didn't get verified in order to avoid copyright issues, stuff like that. So that's how I got started on Vine Sauce, was literally just like, hey, I'm gonna fuck with people on chat roulette, cool? Which I'll tell you right now is gonna be one of my donation incentives. Not to stream that, because... you know, you can't really stream chat roulette without getting some guy's dick on screen. But I can make a video of it. We eventually had to upgrade so that way we were allowed to have more than 50 people watching. And people were very angry. They're like, this community is getting too big. It's got 50 people in chat and I can't watch. It's getting too big. Don't make it get bigger. It's like, I don't think we're ever going to really get new streamers. You know, there are some people who are, like, cool, like Mike or Andrew. People like that. How the fuck do I get up? I think I need to get up somehow. Get on one of the platform. Yeah, I just need to figure out what platform I need to get to. Yeah, nowadays it's about 1,000-something viewers, so... like, even... oh, there we go. There's a little platform. So... Hugbees, yeah. They're cool. But, you know, I don't know. GPM is sort of new, but he was around back in the day, too. He was back around, in the early days. He was on a different stream, but he did the first... when we first upgraded to have, like, an actual, like... website. He was the first one to design a Vine Sauce website. So, he's not been a part of the Vine Sauce family for 6 years, but he's been in the area for so long. Anyway, back to this game, because this shit just happened. This one you have a lot less, area to grip onto. Is that stream dead? As far as I know, yes, but I don't know. If you've been around in a pretty major part of the community for 6 years, then Vinny might say yes, but I wouldn't really count on it at this point. There it is. There we go. I don't know what this is doing to the bitrate. I hope that the upgraded internet allows me to play this game without it being too fucked up. And speaking of Mike, there he is. Thank you for the host, man. This is not a spot anymore, so. Occasionally, I think he does loops or something, so. Oh! Speaking of which, he's doing a little bit of a barrel roll. Oh. I think there's one on each wingtip. Shit. Oh, not a good place to grab. No. Shit. Okay. Oh. Okay. I try my best to respond to questions in chat. I mean, you know. Don't give people like Vinny and Yol a hard time if they don't, just because they have a lot more viewers than I do, but it's, you know, I'm at a manageable size. I don't think we were pure stream back in the day. Lot less politically correct, lot less professional, but you know what? That's okay. I think that was me flying off like a jackass there. Hey, cat. Yeah, I think that was me flying off on the cutscene there. Well, I guess I'm gonna go now. Aggro? Where are you at? Oh, shit. The days of two chats. Yeah, that was a thing. Did I put the beans on yet? I don't know what the fuck that means. You can hold on if you keep the things. Okay. I don't know. Honestly, I've suggested this in the past, and I'll suggest it again. If you want to be a Vinesauce streamer, you're better off just doing what we did and starting from scratch and slowly building up a community like we did. You know, ask in chat, you know. Let me ask right now. Are there any people in chat right now who would want to have a drama-free, good, tight-knit community of streamers? Like Vinesauce, but not Vinesauce. You're all just crawled out of Mike's Subnautica stream. If the answer is yes, you know, get in contact with those people after the stream is over. Maybe you guys can set up a little bit of a network going. Because that's one of the best things you can do as far as streaming, is be in a network of people, because you can't always be on your game. You are going to get sick. You are going to have bad days. You are going to be anxious or depressed or whatever, and you're not going to have days where you can stream. And the best way to get a community going and keeping it going is doing something where you're with other people. And you can have stuff where, even if you're not on point the entire stream, if you're with someone else on stream, they can be on point. So, if you guys want to start up a stream where you know, gather together, take note of the people who said yes in chat are. See if you can contact each other, maybe on Steam or something. You know? It was as casual as that when me and Vinny and Yol and all that got started, so. Exactly, Kat.
Thy next foe is... A giant lurks underneath the temple. It lusts for destruction, but a fool it is not.
Part of it is, you know, Victoria, is, like I said, the idea of a drama-free community. Like, you gotta keep it going. You know? Like, when I started streaming 6 years ago, I was, 22? God damn, I'm old. You know, just have a good time of it. That's the main thing. Don't make it a huge deal. Just you and some other people who want to have a good time. You know? It doesn't have to be the next fine sauce. It doesn't have to be, you know, the best thing ever. It can just be you guys having a good time. People appreciate that honesty. And that's what I recommend. Find some people who you can agree with and have a good time with. How do I save? No, I want to save. Don't stream just to be big or have the money or whatever, because the money, like, I'm even still now at this point where we have a chat that is, you know, this active and this reliable, and with the number of views that I can get on YouTube, even still not making enough money to be able to pay for this apartment, you know? So don't do it for the money. Don't do it for the fame. Do it because you enjoy it. Circle? It's not giving me a prompt. So, there it is. I have to be closer. I'm dumb. I think it already saved. In fact, I'm pretty sure it did, but I'm one of those nervous savers, if you know what I mean, where you save more than you actually need to. There are better, easier ways of making money than streaming or doing YouTube. For instance, working at McDonald's, being a janitor, working in a sweatshop. Those are a little bit easier than making enough money. Not as far as like the actual work, but more along the lines of actually being able to make a decent amount of money. Not a living wage by any rate, but you know, neither is streaming. Unless if you're ultra popular. But, that's enough of all that. The best thing as far as capture software goes, in my opinion, is OBS, which is what I'm using right now. And, I feel like it's pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and, drop out of the game. Yeah, I don't want to work in, fast food or customer service ever again. I don't mind being, like, whatever customer service that I'm giving you guys right now, because it doesn't feel like I have to fake it. There's a name for this, and I forget what it's called. I believe it's cognitive dissonance. That when you're at a job, it's like, you know, the customer's always right, and you gotta smile. Like, that apparently, they've done some studies, and apparently it fucks with your head really bad, and you are likely to have really bad depression if you have to keep that up. Because you're like, well, I have to be happy, but I don't feel happy because this guy's treating me like shit. What's wrong? What's wrong with me as an individual? And then you start getting really fucked up in the head because of it. The problem in you is the problem is that some customers are just assholes. So, apparently this is worse in the States than it is other countries. So, I always, whenever I meet anyone, I meet them at the same level they're meeting me. If you're treating me like a human being, I'll treat you like a human being. If you're treating me like you're a fan of mine, I'll, you know, treat you like a human being, but I'll treat you like you're a fan of mine. You know what I mean? If you're treating me like a customer, I will treat you like a human being, but also like I'm your customer. You know what I mean? It's partly just what it's like to grow up in Texas. And I noticed this in Michigan when I went through the Detroit airport. People, it's a very southern thing to try and have a conversation, you know, and not actually, like, when I go to the grocery store, for example, and the person is, like, you know, checking out my bananas and, scanning my cucumber or whatever, I try and have a conversation with them. I'm like, you know, hey, how's your day going? It's pretty busy in here today. Yeah, you know, that sort of thing. Tried to pull at the Detroit airport. They're like, your total is $450. It's like, whoa, all right. I'll leave then. Anyway, let me show you the art real quick. This first one, I gotta just explain how good this one is. Because I don't think you guys necessarily will get this right off the bat. I have countless number of people asking me how to draw a gas mask. It is one of the hardest things to draw. It's really awkward. This gas mask is really well drawn, along with the rest of it. It is accurate. It is good. And it looks right. And then the rest of me looks good, you know? I look hot as hell. Who did this? Laura M. A lot of people in the comments are saying, like, holy shit. Yeah. This is good art. This is really good art. And you got my pointy beard. Thank you. So thank you for that. Then we've got this one by Van Bader. I feel like this one is animated, but it's not. It just feels like we're about to start doing a little bouncy number thing. It feels a little bit Miitomo, you know? I like that I have a little, thing. I don't remember what that's called. A collar? Reverend collar? It's good. And all of us have, like, a slightly different outfit. Jen's is a little bit more stylized towards the, Harlequin thing. Vinny has just a regular t-shirt on. I need to get one of these, but I think it would be a little weird to walk around, whatchamacallit. Which one's Mike? I don't think any of them are. So it's Vinny, Jin, Yul, KY, GPM, and myself. That is my gay guess. That is my gay. It's Rhythm Heaven. Okay, that makes sense. It does have a very Rhythm Heaven feel to it. That's based on the Frog Hop song in Rhythm Heaven. I've never played Rhythm Heaven. It's partly because I have no rhythm. And then this one was done. This one was done by Sugar Shock, and it says Fuck Wasp. And I believe he's got a swastika armband and a gun. And he probably supports building a wall. List of things that WASP had done to terrorize the planet. Supported Hitler. Are the cause of 80% of both white-collar and street crimes combined. Causes cancer rates to skyrocket in 1952. Pissed in your food while you were not looking and then flew away. Vandalism and public intoxication. This was good in of itself. This addition is just makes it that extra little bit. So I appreciate that. Let me zoom in on it. That's good. For as much time as you had to actually draw that, that's pretty fucking good. It's pretty good regardless, actually. Anyway, fuck WASP. Goddamn alcoholic WASP. I have some gushers here, so I'm gonna eat those. Good. Did you know they actually say what's in them now? So this one doesn't say, which means that it's just a mixed bag of them. I like gushers. Anyway, we should probably go rather than just eating gushers on stream. WASPs are kind of useful, though. Sounds like a WASP apologist over here. Oh, yeah. They're good. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time. I hope you enjoyed it. There's a couple of new shirts I should point out, but honestly, save your money for now. They'll be there forever. And I believe after the charity, I got an email from the company I go with. And we're going to have a sale that starts a little bit after the charity. So I'll link the thing. So y'all should kind of wait. You'd probably buy your shirts after the charity. And they'll be on sale then anyway. So save your money for the charity. And I'll see you guys next time. Gushers. Goodbye.